cineinc.com.
Khushwant Singh and the sense of humor, why?
Well, you know, he never took himself seriously, and he felt that what we Indians lacked was enough of a sense of humor. So that's why when I was talking about him and his great qualities, one of the qualities I mentioned was his sense of humor. I'll tell you a few anecdotes. One, of course, is the one which he used to love to show everybody. This letter that he got from one of his critics, obviously, which came from abroad, I think probably from America and probably from some Khalistani, and it was addressed to Khushwant Singh, bastard India, and it got to him.
And the letter reached.
The letter reached. So he would show everybody. He said, look, the letter reached me. You know, the postal department knows me. So that was his kind of, you know, sense of humor. So
this is one of those things. And there's another thing that you narrated.
Yeah, well, you know, he also used to always end his column with a joke. And very often it was a Santa Banta joke. Now, Santa Banta is two sardars, Santa and Banta. And these jokes were quite, you know, well known at that time. And the funny thing is that these jokes were sent to him by sardars themselves.
Yes.
So he would sort of, you know, change them around a bit, edit them a little bit. But he would have a Santa Banta joke at the end. And once he got a very stern official letter from what is known as the Shrimani Gurdwara Prabandhak Committee.
SGPC.
SGPC, which is the highest spiritual authority of the Sikhs.
It is.
And this official letter said, please stop publishing your Santa Banta jokes. So my dad thought about it for a little while. He used to send everybody postcards, you know, and sort of scribble thing. So he just took out a postcard and sent it to them back to the SGPC with just three words, go to hell. And he never heard from them again.
Never heard anything from the SGPC?
Oh, God.
So, and there was another incident about, not incident, but then interesting anecdote about governor's wife.
Yeah, well, you know, he got into the diplomatic service. He first practiced as a lawyer because he did his law from this college here, you know, King's College. He studied law, he did law, and then he practiced law in Lahore. He didn't like it very much, not a very good experience. So when independence came, they were looking for more people to join the Indian diplomatic service, Indian foreign service. So he applied. He did badly in his written exams, but at the interview, they gave him 100% marks. And I'll tell you why.
He got 100% marks. He was selected for the diplomat's post.
He just made it into the interview, you know, because the interview is the last thing. Now, if he had not done well in the interview, he would have not got in. But they asked him three questions, and amongst the people interviewing was the great Harold Lasky. He was, you know, on the board, and there were mainly English people at that time. So they asked him three questions. One was, why do you want to join the diplomatic service? And the usual answer that people used to give was, oh, we want to serve the nation, you know, that's our duty and all that kind of stuff. My father's answer was, I'm told the salary is pretty good. So there was great...
Absolutely to the point and yeah, true as well.
So there was great laughter and they liked that answer. Well, that was, you know, my father, candid, full of humor.
So that's one question.
The second question was, you've been a lawyer. What do you think of the law and how it's practiced? So he said, you know, I found that in India, this was when India and Pakistan were together, in India it takes several years to resolve some dispute, while here in England it's done within 6 months. So he asked, I wondered, he said, why? How come the British lawyers make any money?
Within 6 months it's done, sorted out, done and dusted. Okay, there was another thing.
Yeah, the last one was, he was asked how many guns are fired when the governor's wife has a baby. So my father thought for a while. He says, I'm sorry, I don't know how many guns are fired. All I know is that the ADC to the governor is fired.
The ADC to the governor is fired. Brilliant.
So he got 100% marks for that interview, and that's how he got into diplomatic service. And the first place he was posted to was England and the High Commission, which is just round the corner from...
Yes, we are here at the King's College.
Which is round the corner from the High... So anyway, humor played a very important part in his writings, and I think his readers loved him for it. There was a kind of irreverence to his humor, but there was always a serious purpose behind it, you know. So it was a humor with a purpose. And whenever he used to go abroad, he used to ask, you know, the people he met there, tell me your latest jokes, you know. Poland he went to, I remember once, and he came back with a lot of Polish jokes. And he would publish them in his columns. So he was always looking out for something to lighten the atmosphere. But as I said, there's always some serious purpose to that humor.
Of course. Is there any favorite of yours? Khushwant Singh's, one of his jokes? Or maybe your favorite, something that he said, or maybe he told you or shared?
So many Sardarji jokes that that I can't remember any one of them, but they were, and the most of the Sardarji jokes were sent in Punjabi, you know, so they don't sound the same in English. But once I remember the word for ironing board, that iron and wife is the same.
Istri.
Istri. So one Sardarji goes to another and asks, you know, can I borrow your istri? So that Sardar brings out his wife. He says, no, not this istri, but the kind that gives the current. So the other Sardarji says, try and touch her and you'll see. So that's the kind of one Sardarji joke I remember.
Ajay, this is so good. But at the same time, you are his son. And was he okay with you in terms of cracking jokes and, you know, having a banter or discussing something in a lighter vein? Or was he serious with you all the time?
He was much more serious with me. You know, he was always... He gave the impression of being such a very liberal, free-thinking person. But with his own children, he was quite conservative and strict. With other people, he was very liberal and
okay, you say conservative with his children, in what sense?
Well, I remember once when I was still in ending my school. And, you know, we were just starting to go out with girls and all that at that time. And I went to some party, and there were some girls who came along. I gave them a lift or something. And the parents knew that I was taking their daughters, you know, some of them out. And I was meant to be back by a certain time, 10 o'clock or 10:30. and I came back much later than that. And the parents of the girls, because they knew that I had gone out, they rang up my father and my mother saying, you know, what's happened to our daughters? They were going out with your son. So I came back late. So my father told my mother to remain quiet. I'm going to talk to him. So I was given a real shouting at that I should not have done this because the girl's parents were ringing up. And I still remember that incident where he let me have it, verbally of course, let me have it. So I just, after that, was very, very careful as far as taking girls.
And was he strict with your sister as well?
Yeah, same as my sister. But again, you know, very liberal-minded. My sister married a Hindu. It didn't make any difference to him at all. You know, you would have thought that, but he was, you know, though he was not religious, he was very proud of being a Sikh. And maintaining the turban and the long hair was important to him. So when I cut my hair, because I'm not an orthodox Sikh in that way, he was very upset and very hurt. So that's what I mean by him having a mixture of being very liberal and also very conservative.
Okay, being the son of such an illustrious man, such an iconic figure, I mean, is it a kind of a baggage, some sort of a burden?
Or I got quite
how
used,
did you live with it?
I got quite used to it and very proud of, you know, being. But I left home at the age of 18 because I joined university in England at Cambridge. And then I started my job in Bombay after that. So I never really lived with my father after the age of 18, though I saw a lot of him. But I got used to the fact that he could be outrageous. I remember an incident when during the emergency, I was in America, and a friend of mine had taken me to a party where they didn't know who I was. And those were the days when my father was supporting Indira Gandhi in the emergency, and there was a lot of polarization. So at this party, somebody was talking about the emergency, and they didn't know who I was, so he got very worked up. He said, I wish somebody would go and shoot that Khushwant Singh. And my friend who had brought me there said, I'm sorry to say, but his son is standing right next to you there. So I remember awkward incidents like that sometimes used to happen.
Right, okay. And how would you like to remember him? Kind of a short and precise tribute as a son or as a journalist.
He was somebody who was totally true to himself. You know, he didn't care for the consequences. He was against all kind of religious fundamentalism, Hindu, Muslim, and Sikhs. And he had threats to his life from the Sikh extremists. But he couldn't care less. He once even said, I wish I died at the hands of a Sikh terrorist. He even said that.
Really?
Yeah, he said that. Because he was so much opposed to the fundamentalism that he saw all over him. And another thing that he was something very, 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 very sort of devout about was the importance of dissent. You know, he would have been very unhappy with what's happening in India at the moment, because even towards the, you know, end of his life, he was feeling that the area for dissent is becoming less and less. And he'd been very unhappy about that, because that's one of the great things he acquired from his English education and from his years he spent here in England. The importance of tolerance, of secularism, and of dissent, and humor. He, I think, got his sense of humor living in England, getting an English education.
Rahul Singh, thank you very much.
Cine.com